now, so there's just about 25 days left in the month. But you are saying that you can still make the best of it. Tell us why.
Okay, so let me start with a quote from Buddha, who says that the problem is we think we have time. But from my own observation, I realize that in the beginning of the year, we overestimate the time we have, and then towards the end of the year, we underestimate the time that we have. 25 days is a long time to do something. It is good to start to take stock, to start a plan for the year, but at the same time, it's important to know that there's still a lot we can achieve within this year, right? So even if there are goals that you're pursuing, you set a goal in the course of the year and you've not achieved it yet, due to some reasons, you can still continue pursuing, sticking to the process that got you there. I mean, persistence is key. You know, you should just try one more time. Somebody said she wants to get married, for example, in 2018, and it has not happened yet. Hey, I'm not saying that within 25 days that you find a man and then you get married. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is that the process that leads to that marriage, I mean, that leads to that wedding can still happen.
Yeah.
So you can stick to it. So it's about not giving up, not thinking that time has gone, not underestimating the power of the 25 days that we still have. And there are a lot of things that we can do with this 25 days. Number one is we can decide to sit down, take a stock, and reflect on the past 11 months. How have I been? What have I done? You know, how well have I done the things that I said that I would do this year? What are the factors that helped me to maximize my movement? What are those factors that came in as a distraction? How do I ensure that in the new year that that doesn't play out? That's one good thing to do. Another good thing to do, the holidays are here, by the way.
Yeah.
Another good thing to do is to make sure that this holiday season that you connect with people. And in connecting with people with Christmas, I'm not saying that anybody should go and borrow some money to buy fancy things and for Christmas, because, you know, when January comes, January is always like 4 months in a row. It is 4 weeks, but it looks like 4 months. Why? Because people have spent a lot of money in December and then you're trying to recoup in January.
Yeah.
During the holiday season, visit people, greet people. You know, people that you probably could not meet with in the course of the year. Everybody's busy up and down. So spend time with family. It's part of what will make your new year good and great. It's part of maximizing this moment. Spend time with family. Spend time with colleagues. I mean, some business partners, some of your prospects as a salesperson. They probably did not buy your product or your service or your idea this year. Bond is a good time to bond with them. But what we should know is that the next 25 days still offer us great opportunities to set new goals and achieve them within the time, to stick to the process that will lead to the achievement of a particular goal, and also to keep our relationships.
Yeah. Now, there are lots of people who said, you see it on social media, see it everywhere. People are saying 2018 was not a great year for them. Maybe they started out well, got such great hopes, many things that they want to achieve and all of that. And now they're hearing you say all this and they're saying, look, I'm just looking forward to the new year. I don't really think I can do that much in 25 days and all of that. What would you say to such people?
So it's about hope. Hope, and H-O-P, I call it holding on with a persistent expectation. Hope. The moment we give up, the moment we lose hope, that is where we've lost it. So you started the year with high energy on the things that you want to achieve, and you keep on pursuing and keep on pursuing, and you got hit. Now, when you get hit, it's not the time to relax and sit down. It's to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and start to remake yourself, to look for other ways to achieve the thing that you said you want to achieve. Yeah. It's about hope. It's about hope. And saying that 2018 is not a great year is perspective. For me, it's been an absolutely fantastic year. Not because I made all the money that I wanted to make, but because I made some giant strides. I mean, for example, in this season, we're celebrating our 10 million champions milestone in our organization.
Congratulations.
You know, thank you. We're celebrating our 10 million champions milestone in our organization. Not that everything has been easy. Not that the year handed us all the opportunities. We sought opportunities, but we are still seeking opportunities. So it's about hope, H-O-P, holding on with a persistent expectation, holding on till 31st of December that things will happen, holding on and not giving up at all.
Now, talk to us about, there are certain people who maybe they're planning for the Christmas season and the New Year celebration specifically, people who own small businesses and they're still looking at making money. You know, we're talking about maximizing this final moment. What should I do to ensure that, look, I get the maximum, either in finances, in relationships, whatever it is that I'm doing, ensuring that I get the best out of this December.
Okay, cool. Now, it depends on the kind of business.
Yeah.
Some businesses are seasonal. I saw something online funny yesterday that there's a fashion designer somewhere that is taking cloth from someone that he will not get it ready before Christmas.
Yeah.
But he's making a promise. I saw something like that online yesterday. So it depends on the kind of business. So if you are into fashion designing, you know, some people want to buy Christmas cloth. You know,
exactly.
Quote.
Yeah.
If you are into, if you're selling maybe rice, some oil, things that people use this season. Of course, what you want to do is to ensure that before now that you've started marketing them.
Right.
And even if you've not started, the things you can do right now, start engaging them. There are opportunities. You can use social media to reach out to them. You can use many opportunities to reach out to them. Just make sure if your business is seasonal and this season is your season, you want to maximize the moment. You may probably want to drop your price so that more people can patronize you, so you increase your profitability.
Mm.
If your business is not seasonal, please invest in relationships this period. You know, what people do this period, if I just buy a gift or something, a token, send it to people just to let them know that you are thinking about them, that you remember them, and gift work wonders. I've seen this happen. And it doesn't matter how big the recipient of that gift is, what most people think of, hey, it's thinking about me.
Mm.
Then what you realize is that even in, for those who want to, whose businesses are not seasonal, and you want to latch on a relationship in the new year, you realize that people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care.
Indeed.
So giving gift is a way of showing that you care. And then people will want to listen to you some more, because it's important, you know, that you are touching the heart before you ask for a hand. Giving gift is a way of touching the heart before asking for a hand.
Wow. Thank you so much, Abiola Champ-Salami, for joining us again this morning, talking about how to maximize this month of December 2018. No matter how the year has been, you can still do some great things before the end of the year. All right. We'll see you again soon.
Hopefully. Definitely.
All right. Heading over to the kitchen now. I'm sure ML.